Second Thursday update, writehru, Sony / Marvel's Spider-Man, No Way Home is slinging up mega numbers in its early overseas play. The full Wednesday launch in 15 markets has come in at $43.6 million. The Jon Watts-directed film has also set multiple records, and is looking to blow past industry projections for the weekend. Domestic previews start today. As we reported yesterday, the Tom Holland-starrer set a pandemic-era opening day record in Korea on Wednesday. Also yesterday, it scored the best Wednesday launch ever in the UK with £7.63 million, $10.1 million. That debut topped the $6.6 million first day of No Time to Die, which bode on September 30th. The Wednesday in the UK is Sony's biggest opening day of all time there, and, anecdotally, better than any day of either of the previous Bond movies, Skyfall and Spectre, which Sony handled. Also on Wednesday, No Way Home grabbed 190 million Mexican pesos, $9 million, in Mexico for the biggest ever opening day in the market. This comes in above Avengers, Endgame when excluding that film's previews. In France, NWH had a Wednesday start of $4.3 million, which was 2% over Avengers, Infinity War. Russia logged the number 3 all-time opening day with $3.5 million, and Italy gave Sony its best opening day with $3.4 million. There is also encouraging news out of Asia, with Taiwan grossing $1.4 million on Wednesday, a Sony record. Meanwhile, in Korea today, No Way Home added an estimated $3.3 million for a running two-day come of $8.58 million and a 95% share of the market, where a 10 p.m. curfew will be installed from Saturday. The Korea figure for Thursday is not included in the total above. We will be updating throughout the weekend. Previous, Wednesday, Sony / Marvel's Spider-Man, No Way Home grossed an estimated $5.28 million in Korea on its first day today. This is significant for a number of reasons. Korea has been extremely soft of late, yet the launch day is 11% over the first day of 2019's pre-pandemic Spider-Man, Far From Home, and is the biggest day one figure for any title of the pandemic era.